So my name is Frank Karlitschek. As mentioned, I'm doing free software and open source for a long, long time. Was board member of the KDE project for some time. Started different initiatives and standardization projects, specifications. 2 years ago, I started the User Data Manifesto initiative. The idea of that was that we wanted to define some basic rights that users should have regarding their data in the cloud and internet age. Because as you all know, we have in democratic countries a very good protection of our homes, right? And for example, it's very clear, right, if someone breaks into our home, that is actually a crime, and it's really good, clearly defined what the police can do. But actually in a digital age, it's a bit more difficult, right? Who can access which data, who can decide who has access to my data in the cloud. It's a bit more interesting. So this was an initiative that I co-founded. It was supported by the Free Software Foundation Europe, Netzpolitik, or KDE, you know, a bunch of organizations. But I'm probably most well known nowadays by for founding the OwnCloud project. So I founded this 6 years ago. The idea behind OwnCloud is that it's basically can something similar or the same than Dropbox or Google Drive or OneDrive, but it's completely free software, open source, and you can run it wherever you want. So you can basically inside your organization or even at home or in your university or in your company build up a service for your users which can do the same than this proprietary centralized cloud services, but open source and decentralized. This developed nowadays into one of the biggest open source projects, it seems. We have over 850 contributors that write code for this project, so it's a bigger group nowadays, which is great. I also founded 4 years ago a company around OwnCloud. So we are a Boston-based company who offer OwnCloud for bigger enterprises. We have about 65 employees at the moment, and customers are CERN, Switzerland, or ARD, it's like the biggest German radio and TV network, or Deutsche Bahn is the German railway system, and a bunch of banks that I can't say the names, unfortunately. But it seems that a lot of organizations nowadays really want to protect their data. So this is what we do. So what is cloud? As already mentioned, it's a bit hard to define, right? Or easy, because there are so many definitions. So cloud, you probably already all know what this is. It's basically that you give your hardware or your infrastructure or your platform or your application or your data to someone else to run it for you, basically some kind of IT outsourcing in a way, right? There's different ways to do this. I'm sure we can talk about this later. But it's basically trusting someone else to run your IT in certain ways. Which is great, right? That can help you with running your applications, managing the data, storing your files, doing all the heavy lifting. That's great. Unfortunately, we all know that the dominating platforms and solutions are, there are only a few of them, right? There's Amazon, obviously, as the market leader, and there's the Google platform, and there's Azure from Microsoft. Already mentioned the deal with the Deutsche Telekom. So there are only a few vendors, basically the big ones, and a few open source alternatives. I'm sure we talk about this here. But the market leaders, actually, there are very few proprietary vendors, and they're all very centralized. It's just a bunch of companies who do this. They're all in North America, well, it seems that those organizations, they run the IT of most of the world very soon, in some ways, which is interesting in different ways. It's some kind of lock-in effect. The question, what happens with the IT sector in Europe? lots of interesting questions. So the dependency, obviously, is a big factor, right? So if those cloud companies, those cloud platforms, centralized cloud infrastructure things, basically are the foundation of everything, me, and with me I mean the consumers, as the governments, as the enterprises do with IT in the future, if this all runs on these platforms, then obviously we have a very strong dependency on those organizations, companies. That's a, can be a challenge. The question is, is this a good thing, good future? Then we all saw the news about safe harbor, right? I mean, it's like, it seems that some people nowadays think that those organizations in North America don't respect the data privacy laws good enough. We have in Germany or in Europe, at least in lots of areas in the world, beside the US, data protection, very important. Then the growing question about around espionage, right? So more and more question. There are some documented cases like Boeing, Airbus, and it's like an interesting topic, I think. And last but not least, of course, the question, what happens with the IT sector in Europe if basically the operating system of the future, like the cloud platforms, if this is all running, well, somewhere else, basically. So I think that what we need is we basically have to turn this cloud thing around in a way that it becomes decentralized and federated and distributed. Because it's, I personally find it a bit strange, it's a strange feature, future, when I imagine that basically most of the files and most of the people in the world are stored on the servers of like three or four companies. That's a bit strange. So in different ways. So I think in the future we have to turn this around and basically have more like a mesh network of different providers, different organizations who can run cloud infrastructure, parts of the cloud, and they should be able to talk to each other via open protocols and open standards, as mentioned. And obviously we have to collaborate on that to make this possible. The challenge with open standards is, of course, well, I think we're all long enough in the business, we know the challenges. The Gartner hype cycle is a very interesting theory. It basically says that cloud computing is so early in the cycle that all the big players have no interest in open standards. I mean, we do, sure, but I mean, if you, the big players stop, right, they're still in land grab mode. They all want to make their data silos bigger. So I don't know if you saw this, but 10 days ago there was a discussion at IETF, one of the big standardization bodies of the internet. There was a proposal to create a standard for file synchronization that you can basically, with different operating systems, different clients, synchronize your files with different backends. And this was killed by Dropbox and some other cloud vendors from the US, because they obviously have no interest in interoperability, right? I mean, they want to lock in their users instead of doing the opposite. So it seems that it's really hard to create standards in this area. So that's a challenge. Obviously, another thing that we want to have is open source. I mean, obviously with open source we can work around lock-in effects, and it's a good way, good vehicle to drive open standards forward. So I think, it, to summarize it, it's, I think the movement, the cloud movement at the moment is in a way a threat and an opportunity at the same time. Threat is basically, if you're not careful enough, then we are heading into a very centralized IT future. But on the other hand, it's also the opportunity that if you are able to establish open standards, the right open source, open platforms, right, like here on the table and all these other companies who work in this area, the open source platforms that speak the same language, the same specifications, the same APIs, that are interchangeable, and data can be migrated, as mentioned, then we can actually have a future where we can or stimulate and drive the IT sector in Europe forward, have a federated infrastructure, and also protect our interests in the long run. Thank you.